Some more cooperation gate combination 14, 15, 16. That was not as smooth as it could be, but it was not bad at all. According to the split, there is a huge gap because of 50-second penalty in gate number 6. But naturally, we are mentioning just the unofficial results. That's what we are always stressing out, because we are not allowed to, as commentary, to run in the gate. On our personal point of view, despite we have, for example, a pretty nice view on the gate number 17 from the top of the tower. That's absolutely stunning view, and we can see it absolutely clearly what's happening in this very gate. But we cannot add commentary from our perspective. We can only talk about what we can see according to the unofficial results that we are receiving from the referees, from judges who are on the left side of the course, because we are live receiving their decisions, and that's why we are talking about unofficial results, because naturally there will be time to say something against it after the race of category K1 man, as well as in all other classes of Canoe Slalom. That was really smooth. Sergey Maymistov, representing Russia, was really fast in gate number 17. Number 16 was not bad at all, while I have to mention there was a Dutch 2-second penalty for Russian Pavlov with starting number 38.
Startovní čísla, která se k nám teď dostávají, tak to jsou závodníci, kteří už také startovali buď to ve světových pohárech na mistrovství Evropy nebo na mistrovství světa. Sergey Maymistov je závodník z Ruska, který dojíždí do cíle. Tady to bude také na hranici, nakonec třetí pozice, tak třetí místo pro ruského závodníka. Se startovním číslem 37, zajímavý závodník Tim Machiner, závodník, který se hodně dlouho...